Okay, well, let's talk about what else is happening in the UK. Right-wing, or Europe, I should say, because right-wing political parties have made significant gains in the European Parliament elections, which has led to French President Emmanuel Macron calling a snap election. Roger, why are more people deciding to lean to the right?
I think it's really quite interesting. I think that people in Europe are just sick of the lefty, woke, controlling, ridiculous, red tape way of life under the European Union, and they want out. And it's really quite paradoxical because, I mean, the UK, Britain Brexited 4 years ago to get away from that stuff. And the Europeans are now, 400 million, the majority of them voted basically to be Brexiteers and dump all the left climate net zero, all the rest of this stuff, while Britain is drifting or racing towards total wokeism, mass immigration, open borders, net zero, climate change, transgender. Whatever the Labour people can think of to make themselves popular, it's going the other way. It's just that, as we say in Britain, there's nowt so queer as folk. I mean, it's amazing. Positions have just flip-flopped. Now, you mentioned Macron, and he's a very good example because he's been very badly beaten by Marine Le Pen's party, and he took a hell of a gamble. I mean, he's still young, like Sunak. Sunak knows that he's totally messed everything up, but he's got plenty of money and, he's young and he can go do other things and he'll be fine. And Macron is a bit the same, So he took this gamble saying, look, if you don't give me a mandate, then okay. If you don't, tell me that I'm still, tell me you love me, then good. The difference is that with Sunak, he's gone. He's toast. With Macron, he still is there for 3 years. He just sits there as a lame duck. So it was a daring gamble for him to take, but he was basically saying to all these right-wing people, put up or shut up.